Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the semiconductor memories and we will also discuss the types of the semiconductor memories. When we talk about the semiconductor memories, we widely use them for storing the digital data. Whenever we are talking about the semiconductor memory or the magnetic tapes, we are using them for storing the digital data. Now, the next one is that we replaced all the older ones by the semiconductor memories because of their smaller size. They have a large capacity and the reliable working. That is, the data corruption is lesser in the semiconductor memories as compared to the older ones. What we can say about the semiconductor memories is that it is an array of memory cells, that small memory cells has been fabricated on a single silicon chip, and that is nothing but the semiconductor memories. That's why it is very small in size and it is available in many sizes like 1K, 32K, 64K, and so on. So this is the one of the most important feature of the semiconductor memory, smaller in size and large capacity or large type of space is provided by them. Now let us talk about the types of the semiconductor memories. It is basically divided into two types. First one is RAM, second one is ROM. RAM stands for random access memory, and ROM stands for read only memory. The name itself is capable of explaining the working of the semiconductor memory part 1, that is RAM. It is accessing the memory, or we can say that it is a volatile memory. What we can understand by this memory RAM is that, first of all, it is a volatile memory that it can be easily erased. Second one is that it is also known as read and write memory. So what we can understand by read and write memory is that we can write the data into the memory or we can read the data from the memory. Both can be accessed from this kind of memory. It is also subdivided into two parts. First one is known as static RAM. Second one is known as dynamic RAM. Static RAM is also used for storing the data as long as the power is on. It will store the data just like the RAM, but as long as the power is on. It is not required to set or reset the flip-flop again and again. Till the power is on, it will store the data. In this case, the drawback is that if the power is off, suddenly if the power is off, then I will lost my data. This is the disadvantage of the static memory. But as compared to the dynamic RAM, it is faster. Now let us talk about the dynamic RAM. It consists of capacitor. So what we are doing, we are refreshing it again and again. The data is storing again and again. Not like a previous case of the static RAM, that power is on, then till that our data is saved. In this case, data is saved, but we have to refresh this memory again and again because it consists of capacitor. And it is not faster way of storing the data. Dynamic RAM is not a faster as compared to the static RAM, but it is cheap as compared to static RAM. So its advantage is that it is fast in nature and it is cheap in nature. Now let us talk about the ROM, that is read-only memory. ROM is known as non-volatile memory. that is which can't be erased from the CPU. Such a type of memory is known as non-volatile memory. Now it is also divided into many types, but what we can understand from this type is that even if the power is off, this memory will not lose its data. One of the most important advantages and the difference between the RAM and ROM, that the data will not lose even if the power is off. Now let's talk about its types. First one is masked programmable ROM. It is also known as, simply we can call it as ROMs. The main feature of this masked programmable ROM is that the data is permanent, can't be erased even when the power is on or off. It is already inbuilt, the data is already inbuilt inside this memory by the manufacturer. So this is the feature of this masked programmable ROM. Second one is known as PROM, that is programmable read only memory. The basic difference between ROM and PROM is that the data of the ROM is already fixed, but the data of the PROM is programmed, and we use a special method of programming by the help of manufacturer. It is built in such a way that that memory can be accessed in a different way. So what we can say that it has a special program and it is programmed memory. This is also non-volatile, this is also permanent in nature, but the special feature is that it is a programmed memory. So for the once at least, we can programmed this memory. This is the special feature of this memory. Let us talk about the third case. Third one is known as erasable programmable read-only memories, that is EPROM. Now the main feature of this ROM is that it can be programmed by the user many times. It is not a based on a single programming. We are able to program this memory many times. So what we can say that it can be programmed number of times. The user can use the memory or just place this memory in the presence of UV lights, and UV light will erase whatever data or the program is storing in this memory, and once the data is erased, we can program it again. So this is the main feature of the erasable programmable read-only memory. Of course, the reprogrammable time is more, but at least we are able to alter the data or the program in this kind of memory. Last one is so the fourth one is electrically altered programmable read-only memory. This is also known as E-square PROM. Sometimes it is also called as square PROM. Now in this case, the data is altered electrically by applying the electrical signal in spite of exposing them into the UV rays. What we are using, we are just applying the electrical signal or the electrical voltage, and we are trying to erase the memory or the data. Now the method of removal of the memory from the main circuit, we can just process it at the time of our requirement, we will process that memory and we can easily alter the data in a just short span of time. This is one of the most important advantage of the E²PRO as compared to the erasable programmable read-only memory. So this is all about the types of the semiconductor memories. Thank you.